On a beautiful day, Thomas and Jeff are playing with a ball near the banks of a river. Jeff accidentally kicks the ball a little too far. Thomas then goes in the woods to get the ball back. And suddenly, a crocodile appears in front of him. It turns out that the crocodile is not just any crocodile, it is very wise and is able to talk too. The crocodile tells Thomas that if he guesses correctly his next move, then he is free to go. Thomas knows for sure that there are only two things that crocodile can do next. He will either leave him, or he will eat him. Let's assume that Thomas said that he will be eaten by the crocodile. If this is true, then the crocodile has to let Thomas go, but in doing so, he breaks his word and contradicts Thomas's answer. So now, he cannot let him go. This way poor Thomas gets stuck in a cycle, or simply, a paradox. But again, we don't know whether Thomas's answer will be 100% right. So now, let's assume that Thomas's answer will be wrong. So if Thomas is wrong, he won't go free and the crocodile will eat him, but this also contradicts with the crocodile's intention. This will lead us back to the first part of the paradox. It seems that there is no way that Thomas can escape, also there is no way that our green reptile can eat him. Both are stuck in a closed loop with no solution. Anyway, that's what a paradox is about. Thankfully, our Thomas was not scared by the crocodile, and managed to escape from him. The crocodile paradox is an ancient problem that is considered so enduring that in the Middle Ages, the term crocodilite came to be used to refer to any similarly brain-twisting problem. This paradox was created by Karl von Prantl, who was a German philosopher and philologist in around 1843. If you liked our video, then please subscribe to our channel for more interesting videos like this. And as always, do not forget to like, comment, and share the video.